Thomas, I'm very pleased to have you on the Brain Science Podcast today.
It's a pleasure.
I think you're the first guest that I've had from Germany. I did interview Dr. Robert Schleip from Ulm for my other show, Books and Ideas. Where in Germany are you?
Well, I'm at the University of Mainz, where I teach in the philosophy department, but I'm also a permanent fellow at the Frankfurt Institute for Advanced Study, which is modeled after the Princeton Institute for Advanced Study.
Well, I would love to get to go to Germany someday. I have lots of ancestors from there. Before we talk about your book, I was wondering if you would share a little bit of your background and then tell us why you wrote this book.
Well, I studied philosophy in Frankfurt, actually a very simple biography in the city where I also was born, took my PhD there. I've taught all in all at 8 different universities in Germany. I spent a year at UC San Diego. And I'm now hold a chair for theoretical philosophy, that's mostly philosophy of mind and epistemology, at the philosophy department in Mainz. And I also coordinate a research group there which deals with cognitive enhancers and neuroethics, a brand new discipline that looks into the applied ethical issues with new technologies coming out of neuroscience. So I've always had a strong focus in an area we call analytical philosophy of mind, something that is also very prominent and very good in the United States. But my contribution has been to try and open this pure philosophy of mind to interdisciplinary cooperation. That is, I'm also sort of a cognitive scientist. I have for more than 2 decades intensely talked to neuroscientists. It has got to the point that I actually designed experiments myself. So I cooperate very strongly with people also researching the mind, but in empirical fields, also in artificial intelligence and so forth. I try to build a bridge between these philosophy of mind issues and ethical issues. That's where I come from. And this popular book, I basically got bored a couple of years ago and thought you should do something else. And I tried new things. One of them was to create a 3-volume textbook for students, which 2 volumes are out. The 3rd one is coming in April. And I wanted to try if I can write a book that is accessible to normal people, to an interested, educated lay audience, which combines just those issues in the field of consciousness research, of which I think these are the important issues everybody should know about. So it's a combination of ethical and anthropological questions with these general issues like, what is a conscious self? What is consciousness in the first place? What is the relationship to the brain and so forth? I mean, we scientists, professors, tenured professors, we live off taxpayers' money. We also have something like an obligation to explain to those people that pay our salary what actually is perhaps critical or dangerous or what is especially interesting about all this new research that's happening in this field. And it's just an attempt to communicate some of these results.
In a way, what I'm doing is very similar, although I'm not doing it on the taxpayers' money. But I agree that there's a need for scientists to communicate with the public. And that's one of the things I try to do with my podcast is make an avenue to promote that communication. Some of my listeners will buy your book. Some of them will just listen to the podcast. But at least those people will get the main ideas, even if they don't read the book.
Right. Hopefully.